COVID-19 spreads from person to person mainly through the respiratory route after an infected person coughs, sneezes, sings, talks, or breathes. A new infection occurs when virus-containing particles exhaled by an infected person, either respiratory droplets or aerosols, get into the mouth, nose, or eyes of other people who are in close contact with the infected person. Respiratory droplets may evaporate into droplet nuclei, which remain suspended in the air for prolonged periods of time, causing airborne transmission particularly in crowded and inadequately ventilated indoor spaces, such as restaurants, nightclubs or choirs. It can also occur in healthcare settings, with certain aerosol-generating medical procedures performed on COVID-19 patients. Kissing, physical intimacy, and other forms of direct contact can easily transmit the virus and thus lead to COVID-19 in people exposed to such contact. A person can get COVID-19 through indirect contact by touching a contaminated surface or object before touching their own mouth, nose, or eyes, though this is not thought to be the main way the virus spreads. There is currently no significant evidence of COVID-19 virus transmission through feces, urine, breast milk, food, wastewater, drinking water, animal disease vectors, or from mother to baby during pregnancy, although research is ongoing and caution is advised. The number of people generally infected by one infected person varies. As of September 2020, it was estimated that one infected person will, on average, infect between 2 and 3 other people. This is more infectious than influenza, but less so than measles. It often spreads in clusters, where infections can be traced back to an index case or geographical location. There is a major role of super-spreading events, where many people are infected by one person. It can be transmitted as early as 2 days before developing symptoms, and even if symptoms never appear. People remain infectious in moderate cases for 7 to 12 days, and up to 2 weeks in severe cases. In October 2020, medical scientists reported evidence of reinfection in one patient. Respiratory droplets. A man coughing, with droplets dispersing widely into the surrounding air. The main route of transmission of COVID-19 is respiratory droplets expelled from the mouth and nose when a person sneezes, coughs, or speaks. The virus spreads through respiratory droplets produced when an infected person breathes, coughs, sneezes, or talks. These droplets can land in the mouths or noses of people who are nearby, or possibly be inhaled into the lungs. Spread is more likely when people are in close contact within about 6 feet. Close contact is variously defined. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, defines it as, within 6 feet 1.8 meters, of an infected person for a cumulative total of 15 minutes or more over a 24-hour period. The European Center for Disease Prevention and Control states that close proximity is, usually less than 1 meter, 3.3 feet, apart. The Australian Health Department defines it as sharing an enclosed space for a prolonged period such as 2 hours. Social distancing and the wearing of cloth face masks, surgical masks, respirators, or other face coverings are controls for droplet transmission. The World Health Organization recommends 1 meter, 3.3 feet, of social distance. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends 6 feet 1.8 meters. Aerosols. Airborne transmission of COVID-19 has been shown to occur through aerosols, smaller droplets that are able to stay suspended in the air for longer periods of time. Respiratory. Multiple outbreaks have been reported in indoor locations where infected persons spend long periods of time, such as restaurants and nightclubs. This has particularly shown how the virus can spread through the airborne route. However, there have been several individual cases where COVID-19 was transmitted despite there not being the close proximity required for droplet transmission and where contact transmission was unlikely. These include a choir practice in Washington, a restaurant in Guangzhou, and a tour bus in Hunan. Aerosol transmission of the COVID-19 virus outside of medical facilities has been the subject of controversy, with the WHO initially considering it insignificant, which led to widespread criticism from scientists. In July 2020, the WHO changed its guidance, saying that short-range aerosol transmission cannot be ruled out in these situations. In its new guidance, the WHO cautioned that while viral RNA had been found in air samples, at that time viable virus had not. There were no cases of transmission to health workers exposed to COVID-19 cases when contact and droplet precautions were appropriately used. Experimental studies such as one that found viable virus in aerosols generated using a high-powered jet nebulizer do not reflect normal human cough conditions. The US CDC has also been criticized for delays in informing the public about airborne transmission, with John Allen from Harvard University's School of Public Health writing, "Many scientists have known that airborne transmission of the virus was happening since February. The CDC somehow failed to recognize the accumulating evidence that airborne transmission is important and therefore failed to alert the public." In Canada, the controversy has been attributed to complexities involving the N95 mask supply chain, and fears that it may run out. Medical. A tube and a camera being inserted into the mouth of a patient. Tracheal intubation is an example of an aerosol-generating procedure that carries increased risk of transmission from an infected patient. Some medical procedures performed on COVID-19 patients in health facilities are aerosol-generating. WHO recommends the use of filtering face-based respirators such as N95 masks or FFP2 masks in settings where aerosol-generating procedures are performed, while CDC and the European Centre for Disease Prevention and Control recommend these controls in all situations involving the care of COVID-19 patients. Toilet. There has been concern that toilet aerosols generated by flushing contaminated toilets may spread the COVID-19 virus. WHO recommends that people suspected or confirmed with COVID-19 should use their own toilet. And while flushing, the toilet lid should be down to block both droplets and aerosol clouds. Direct contact. Physical intimacy. A close-up photograph of two people kissing. Kissing carries high risk of COVID-19 transmission due to high levels of virus in the saliva. The virus spreads through saliva and mucus, and kissing can easily transmit COVID-19. It is possible that direct contact with feces, including analingus, may also lead to virus transmission. However, as of July 2020, there have been no published reports of COVID-19 transmission through feces or urine. While COVID-19 is not a sexually transmitted infection, physical intimacy carries a high risk of transmission due to close proximity. Hand washing is a control against direct contact transmission. Others include avoiding kissing and avoiding casual sex. Mother to child. As of July 2020, there were no cases of transmission from mother to baby during pregnancy. Studies have found no viable virus in breast milk. The WHO recommends that mothers with suspected or confirmed COVID-19 should be encouraged to initiate or continue to breastfeed. Indirect contact. Objects and surfaces. A silver-colored door handle on a white door. Surfaces that are often touched, such as door handles, may transmit COVID-19, although is not thought to be the main way the virus spreads. It may be possible that a person can get COVID-19 by touching a surface or object that has the virus on it, called a fomite, and then touching their own mouth, nose, or possibly their eyes. This is not thought to be the main way the virus spreads. Viable virus or RNA has been detected on contaminated surfaces for periods ranging from hours to days, depending on environmental conditions. As of July 2020, there were no specific reports which directly demonstrated transmission via fomites. Although fomite transmission is hard to distinguish from transmission from the infectious person themselves, fomite transmission was still considered a likely mode of transmission. On surfaces, the amount of viable active virus decreases over time until it can no longer cause infection. One study indicated that the virus can be detected for up to 4 hours on copper, up to 1 day on cardboard, and up to 3 days on plastic, polypropylene, and stainless steel. In October 2020, medical researchers concluded the COVID-19 virus can remain on common surfaces for up to 28 days. Hand washing and periodic cleaning of surfaces are controls against indirect contact transmission through fomites. Surfaces are easily decontaminated with household disinfectants, which destroy the virus outside the human body. Disinfectants or bleach are not a treatment for COVID-19, and cause health problems when not used properly, such as when used on or inside the human body. Food and water. There is currently no evidence to support transmission of COVID-19 associated with food. While virus RNA has been found in untreated wastewater, as of May 2020 there is little evidence of infectious virus in wastewater or drinking water. Animal vectors. There are a small number of cases of spread from people to pets, including cats and dogs. Other cases include lions and tigers at a New York zoo, and minks on farms in the Netherlands. In a laboratory settings, animals shown to be infected include ferrets, cats, golden Syrian hamsters, rhesus macaques, cynomolgus macaques, grivets, common marmosets, and dogs. By contrast, mice, pigs, chickens, and ducks do not seem to become infected or spread the infection. There is no evidence that insect disease vectors such as mosquitoes or ticks spread COVID-19. CDC recommends that pet owners limit their pets' interaction with people outside their household. Face coverings are not recommended on pets because covering a pet's face could harm them, and they should not be disinfected with cleaning products not approved for animal use. People sick with COVID-19 should avoid contact with pets and other animals. The risk of COVID-19 spreading from animals to people is considered to be low. Although the virus likely originated in bats, the pandemic is sustained through human-to-human spread. Pets do not appear to play a role in spreading COVID-19, but there are reports from infected mink farms indicating transmission to humans is a possibility. Thanks for watching our video. Make sure you subscribe to receive more video related to COVID-19, COVID-19 symptoms, COVID-19 treatment, and many other everyday health and wellness. Don't forget to leave a comment, hit the like button, and please share our video. Thank you so much for watching. Be safe, and stay healthy.